Digging South Carolina. Now, this episode is back at home. Yep, I finally got back from out of state and sitting around wondering where I'm gonna go digging next, and I get a phone call from an old friend that I haven't seen in years. In fact, I thought he got out of metal detecting. Me and a group, and he was in it, used to hunt together 10 years ago, and everybody kind of like just drifted apart. They either quit digging or, you know, hadn't seen him in years, and I figured they quit. But now, Dwayne Dobson, he called me out of the blue one day. He's actually doing some work for my father-in-law. Dwayne's a plumber, electrician, and he was doing some work for my father-in-law in the Lowcountry, and they got to talking about relic hunting, and my name came up, and Dwayne said, I can't believe, you know, he's still doing it. And, you know, he called me up out of the blue and said, yeah, he's been doing it by himself, and kind of wanted to, he got him a new dais and wanted to hook up and do some digging. So I said, yeah, I gave him my settings on my dais, and he's got a partner that just started digging a couple of years ago, Ron Sullivan, and both of them got daises now, and they got them set up like I told them how to set it up, and we're going out. They recently found a Confederate camp down there in the low country. I think it was just an overnight small camp, but they got some neat stuff out of it, and we'll see if there's anything left. And if we don't find a whole lot there, they got a few more pieces of property to walk. Some permission on property. Don't know if anything's there or not, but we're gonna check that out. So alright, stay tuned. I'm gonna show you what Dwayne pulled out of there so far, and I think Ron got a nice spur out of there too, but they got a bunch of bullets and stuff like that, so I'm sure there's something left. Might not be a lot, but we're gonna check it and see. Alright, be back in a bit with some Civil War relics, and thanks for watching Digging South Carolina. Getting ready to hunt, Ron stumbled on it just walking across the hill and started digging bullets, and they came back, and this is what Dwayne got. He got two solid cast eyes, a little Union officer's cuff button, and a whole drop Spencer. And what we think this is, the road that it's on, Confederates were trying to keep the Union troops, Sherman's army, from coming up, and they were like throwing cutting down trees in front of the roads and stuff just to keep them, you know, harassing them. They really couldn't do much else, just harass them. So this probably was a small regiment, and I think from what has been found so far, it's probably just a overnight camp. And from where it's at, you gotta remember these guys were there in the winter time, and it was like January, it was cold, and so they were kind of like huddled in on a slope down toward a swamp just to keep the wind off of them. So you can just imagine what it was like back then. Pretty rough on these guys, but it was in the bend of a road, on an old road that a lot of troop movement was on. So this is what came out of it so far, and we're gonna see if there's anything left. And well, I got one more thing I want to show you too that came out of there. Let me show you one of the first things Ron got out of there. About a nice Confederate spur. Yep, that was one of his first signals when he was going across that little area where the overnight camp was. Maybe there's another one still in there. You never know, but this little regiment didn't spend much time on that little hill down toward the swamp, but they left a few nice finds. So hopefully we'll be back in a minute with another nice relic. All right, here's Ron. We on this damn little Confederate camp they found over here on the side of the road. There's Dwayne.
So we're gonna do it.
We're gonna see if we can find something out here. I think Confederate soldiers, when they're coming up through here, just probably fell out one night and just camped right on the side of this ridge. What y'all got out of here so far?
Two cast eyes, a
handful of bullets,
staff officer's cuff, and
couple
spurs and all.
A couple of spurs. So we'll see if they left anything. Probably not, but we're gonna check it out and see. Be back in a minute if we find something good. All right, Dwayne and Ron are over there. what they found in Stepford Regional. So I stepped across the road, and the first signal I got sounds good. Sounds good, so let's see what we got. There it is. And we have our first bullet. So, there's stuff on this side of the road too. I don't know what kind of bullet it is. I'll clean it up in a minute and let you see it. I don't even know whether it's fired or dropped. It looks like it's dropped. But... all right, be back in a minute after I clean it up. All right, first signal I got over here. Looks like a small 54 caliber three ringer. And they were finding these on the other side of the road, but they were nose cast and they're considered Confederate. So it's probably a Confederate bullet. All right, not bad. Confederate three ringer. Be back in a bit with something else. I already opened the hole. See what this is. Sounds good too. Not reading just like the other bullet. So I can see it on the ground already. It is a bullet. Yep, another bullet. See what we got. Throw it right there. Oh, this looks Confederate as hell. It's one of those high base Charleston Arsenal three ringers. Yep. All day long. Charleston Arsenal three ringer. That is Confederate. That's number two bullet. I called them boys. I'm like, hey! Got another bullet over here! I don't know. I got this right here. I dug the bullet right there, bullet back there, piece of melted lead right there, and in between the two. Look at this crap. This lay on top of the ground. Look at this.
You never thought it'd been on top of the dirt here in this low area.
I know. Well, you said you checked up there on the hill and you didn't dig anything. Another one of those little 54 calibers.
54?
Yeah. There it is. It's three bullets already, so. All right, we're in.
Might be back that way.
All right, I just dug those Confederate bullets down next to the swamp. Man, what a terrible situation that guy must have been in. This camp was just an overnight camp. These guys were running from Sherman's army, harassing them along the way, chopping down trees in the road, doing whatever they could do just to slow them down, but the war was basically over. This was January 1865, and they didn't stand a chance after they took Savannah and all. I don't even know how some of them kept fighting, but these conditions these poor guys were in, can just imagine what it was like that night in January 1865. That's probably why they were huddled down there in the swamp, because probably just trying to stay warm, do anything they could. But I was standing on the same spot digging the bullets where that guy was sitting over 150 years ago down next to that swamp in the dark. Man, what conditions those guys had to suffer under. That's one reason I like digging Civil War relics so much. It's just the stories this stuff tells is amazing. Now, we didn't find a lot of stuff today so far, but hey, just the history of it is amazing. So all right, we'll be back in a little bit, and hopefully we'll find something else to put. Got another signal right here. And let's see what we got. Sounds good. We're checking a different patch of woods now, right up the road from where the camp was at, but we couldn't find anything else up there. So see if we can... oh, I see this. A big old round block. Man, this thing's huge. It's a big old round block. That was like a 71 caliber. Huh, I wonder if there's anything else around in here. I ought to be back in a minute if I find something else. We didn't find anything else back there where the bullets, and we've been looking for a house site and out in this big field. I think I got a good signal right here. It's iron in here. They said they found flat buttons in here before, so I'm fixing to find out what this is. That was good. It's reading like upper 90s. Like it might be a coin. Uh-oh, yeah, we got a coin. It's silver, but I don't know what it is. I have no idea. Huh, pretty smooth. I'll be back in a second when I figure out what this is. Well, it's not the prettiest thing I've ever seen, but it looks like some kind of Spanish silver coin. Yeah, there's the guy's head. It's about wore out. Yeah, there it is. It's got a hole in it too. Oh well. Can't find a pretty one, but it's silver, I'll tell you. It looks like it might have been in a fire. Got one hole in it or two? Just one. Alright, I'll clean it up a little bit better and try to figure out what it is. All right, back if I find something else. It's getting late, the sun's going down. So far just bullets and this coin, but I guess better than nothing. All right, be back in a bit.